Namaste.
And welcome back to Grow with the Jan Family.
Minanam Anjali Hai.
And today we're talking about U.S. canceling over 1,000 visas of Chinese nationals deeming security risks. Now, this is a good step in the right direction. The article talks about them being part of scientific and engineering and and things where, you know, there could be some stealing involved, which we know has happened before. There's been a few professors that have already been thrown in jail for, you know, selling stuff back to China. So, but these students have ties with the CCP, with the
That's the big thing. Yeah. Like,
yeah. They have ties to the state, to the military, to China's military. And that's the huge part about this. They're not just picking and choosing and saying, like, all the Chinese students. No. Don't get that Trump is being a racist and he's throwing all the Chinese people out of the U.S.
He's still letting them come in. Like, we still have Chinese people coming in for legitimate research.
Yes. We hope that if you're coming here to do research or coming here to do schooling or coming here to get a better life, that you are denouncing what the CCP is doing and you're coming here for the democracy, for the freedom of speech, and to do the research and the work and to be part of the United States of America. So if you're not coming here for good reasons, then yeah, I'm glad he's not letting people in, that they're getting their visas canceled. And, you know, it said they're letting people in depending on, you know, what you're studying. And if you have connections with the military or the CCP, that just makes common sense. We've heard Trump, we've heard Pompeo, we've heard the FBI director talk over and over and over again.
About safety hazards.
Security breach after security breach after security breach. It's like stealing the information and getting it, you know, patenting it before the people that you stole it from can patent it.
Yeah.
And then selling it, you know. The U.S. had given China some medicine to help with the coronavirus when it first outbroke. And they stole that. It was in research development. It wasn't anything that had been patented or had been finished, finalized. It was a work in progress, and they took it, they tweaked it, they patented it, and they tried to resell it back to the U.S. Like,
that's the same with the masks. Like, they bought a bunch of masks and things before
respirators.
Before the coronavirus came, and now they're trying to sell it to everybody.
Right, for higher prices. So this is the stuff with the CCP that we don't agree with. This is why we're here on YouTube, that YouTube gives us this voice that we can, freedom of speech, give our opinions on. Mm-hmm. You know, this is what we want to see the Chinese people do. Like, they should be able to speak out. The people in Hong Kong would like to speak out. The people in Taiwan, Tibet. The monks are burning themselves alive in Tibet to get attention, to let people know how bad it is there. Like, and Uyghur Muslims, like 2 million that are being used,
concentration
camps, they're being shackled, you know, they're using their women for whatever they want. And I was reading something that they're trying to, and I think it was this article, trying to block imports of cotton and tomato products over accusations of forced labor, though there has been no formal announcement. So I'm assuming they're talking about Uyghur Muslims, that they're forcing them to work and do this kind of stuff because they have them in concentration camps. I don't know what else they're going to do with them. Like, they're violating human rights, and nobody has slapped them with anything on that.
Until now.
Well, this is just for the students,
canceling
the students. But this is good. Like, this, we would like to see more. You know, Modi has banned some apps and banned some more apps.
I want to see people banning trade with China. Like, free trade, not fair trade. Well, fair trade, not free trade.
Yeah. Yeah. $500 billion we pay to China.
Just the U.S.
Yes. And I think India is $50 billion a year. Almost 5 billion dollars, you pay them while they sit at the border and inch by inch creep into your country. Yeah. You guys have it tougher. In India, I'm telling you, it's tougher. You have China on the one side border.
Pakistan.
And then you got Pakistan on the other side border.
And you have a bunch of neighbors that pick on you.
Fed by China.
Yeah.
Yeah. And a few others that, you know, we would love to see Trump sign the Tibet bill.
Yeah.
And recognize Tibet as a free country. And I hope many other countries follow suit after that so that hopefully China can unleash its clutches on Tibet and eventually the Holy Dalai Lama can go back. That would be amazing because then that whole side doesn't border with China anymore. It borders with Tibet, which is a peaceful, loving country that believes in Buddhism, that has the Holy Dalai Lama. Like, that would be ideal.
Yeah.
And then you would just have, you know, little Pakistan over on the other side. But like we said in our other video, I think God has a bigger plan, and hopefully in the process of this, we get made in India. We get, you know, better defense systems, you know, making your own weaponry. You know, we just saw the hypersonic missile launch.
Yeah.
And we saw the Rafales being the puja that they did for them and being inducted into the Air Force. Like, these are amazing things. And we know there's some amazing technology that can come out of India. There's so many wonderful things that have come out of India. And so I feel like, you know, you have these neighbors on either side. You've had so many invaders come one after the other from different countries. And this is the time to make defense your number one priority. I know it's in Modi G's plan, and he's, you know, he's got these fighter jets, he's making the border tight, you know, he's working with the Quad, right?
Yep.
But defense. You can still be open arms to people who are welcoming. The U.S., we're not saying no Chinese people can come here. We are completely against the CCP and its policies. We welcome Chinese people, any people from any country that come here in peace, that want a better life, that want to be. But when you come here to have a better life, then the U.S. needs to become your country. And this is the country you need to die for. You know, even if you're not in the military, that's kind of behind it. Like, it becomes your country. Like, Jaden wants to go to the Indian Air Force. You know, he goes there. India becomes his country. And you set foot on that land and you want to be a citizen there, you have to want to also die for your country.
Yeah.
You know, so that has to be the priority. So, not against anybody. It's against the policies that are, you know, silencing people, that are putting them in concentration camps, that are spreading biological warfare weaponry.
And still doing it.
And all kinds of things. And not letting people in to investigate. Not letting people, you know, do their jobs.
Or saying everything's fine in Tibet, but not letting anyone in.
Right. Everything is wonderful in Tibet, but the Tibetan Prime Minister is not allowed to go there. That doesn't make any sense.
Yeah.
Right? And that the Holy Dalai Lama is a terrorist.
Yeah.
So you have a good surrounding. So, and we know China's not going to start the war. There's way too much going on.
No.
In China for them to start it. They just want to pick on you. And they feel like India is the only country they can do it. They can't do it to Japan because Japan has already beaten them. They can't do it to the U.S. because they know the U.S. will also beat them. And they've pissed off Australia. And so, and pretty much the world, I mean, at least a lot of the Western countries, I think the only person on their side is Pakistan.
Yeah.
I don't know how that's going to go down. But we know India is strong, but defense definitely has to be number one. And we'd like to see some more things from Modi G, from President Trump, Tibet Bill, trade.
Trade with India. Made in India.
Made in India. This is the opportunity. That's what I mean.
Yeah.
This is the opportunity. Take hold of it. Made in India. defense, defense, defense. Yeah, so they just will stop picking on you.
Yeah.
I think that's all. They just think they can, and so they keep doing it. And it's annoying. But
show them they can't.
Yeah. Show them they don't... You don't show them the other cheek, like Gandhi said, anymore. You show them two fists, right? At least.
Yeah.
And a Raphael or two. So, all right. Enough about China. We wanted to let you know. We'd like to see these little things that keep coming up. We'd like to see more. And we'll let you know when we find something else, right?
Yep.
So hopefully we'll see you again
tomorrow. Bye.